November 6th, you will hear the words and the new undisputed super middleweight. The only difference is right after that, you'll hear the words and still undefeated.
See you November 6th. You want to see something special on you.
Canelo versus Plant are on the brink of writing boxing history as the two world champions collide, deciding who will lay claim as the first ever undisputed 168-pound world champion on Saturday, November 6, 2021 at the MGM Garden Arena in Las Vegas. To say Caleb Plant is an underdog in this fight is a massive understatement. Some bookies have the IBF super middleweight world champion at a plus 1200 to win, regardless in what fashion, at least at the making of this recording. I agree, Saul Canelo Alvarez is the massive favorite based on all the variables we will discuss today. Still, with those odds stacked against a fighter, regardless of who it is, boxing fans could be in for something spectacular on November 6, 2021, because the biggest upsets in the sport of boxing have happened when most people expected the very least. That is where the intrigue for Canelo versus Plant, apart from the obvious feature that being the coronation of boxing's first ever undisputed super middleweight world champion, lies. Hey ringsiders, what is going on? This is your host, Boxing's Objective Observer. Welcome back to Ringside Stories, or if you're new, we cover boxing and combat sports through mini documentaries, backstories, or in today's case, fight previews. So if you enjoy that type of content, feel free to subscribe, thumbs up, and hit that notification bell for the latest here on Ringside Stories. Thanks in advance for your support and welcome to the channel. With the end of 2021 in sight, boxing offers yet another one for the history books, another anomaly per se, when unified WBA, WBC, WBO super middleweight world champion Saul Canelo Alvarez and IBF super middleweight world champion Caleb Plant battle for the ultimate consolidation in the 168-pound division. So much to unpack, so let's break things down as thoroughly as possible with both fighters' strengths, their unknowns, i.e. question marks, going into this fight, their last fight for reference purposes, to eventually attempt to get a consensus, i.e. Ringside Stories' unofficial prediction, at the end of all of this. So let's take a look under the hood. Number one, their last fights. As much as activity plays a huge role in a fighter's career, so does recovery, which proved to be Team Plant's stumbling block when discussing a potential Canelo-Plant fight in recent memory.
Canelo doesn't have an opponent yet for May. You know, that's something I would imagine would interest you very, very much.
How far is May away? So that means take half a month off after a 3.5 month camp and then go right back to work, right? Mm-hmm. Just so they can try and get me when I'm overworked.
Caleb Plant's last fight was against former IBF world title holder Caleb Truax. Even though Sweet Hands pitched a shutout on all three judges' scorecards, many observers will consider Caleb Plant versus Caleb Truax unimpressive, especially looking at it from Caleb Plant's performance point of view, since this was a 37-year-old Truax who has been stopped in the past. Therefore, many people will be reluctant to give Caleb Plant a chance against better quality opposition, especially a fighter as highly esteemed as Saul Canelo Alvarez. Knowing the fight against Caleb Truax was Plant's final fight in preparation for the Canelo fight. Canelo's last outing was a world title unification bout against undefeated brash Brit WBO champion Billy Joe Saunders. A record-breaking attendance for an indoor event in the United States on Cinco de Mayo weekend saw a dominant display of power from Canelo, eventually forcing Saunders' corner to pull their fighter out before the start of round 9. Canelo's win over Billy Joe Saunders on May 8, 2021 added the division's third major title to Canelo's super middleweight collection after previously beating Callum Smith on the back end of 2020 and Avni Yildirim a few months later. Canelo versus Plant will be the Mexican's fourth fight inside 12 months. So in terms of activity, Canelo Alvarez has a clear advantage over Caleb Plant. Number 2, strengths and unknowns. Canelo versus Plant is a very interesting stylistic matchup. A slick technician will have the height and reach advantage versus an all-around fighter who has three times as many fights as his opponent with only one official loss. So what attributes does Caleb Plant possess that can trouble Canelo? Caleb Plant likes to fight on the back foot, working behind his jab, sometimes throw a multiple of jabs, and then at close range, let his hands go with very fast combinations. As mentioned earlier, Caleb Plant stands at 6'1" and has a 74-inch reach. So on the night, Caleb Plant will be the taller man. Caleb Plant certainly has solid fundamentals as he keeps his head offline using plenty of upper body movement. Caleb Plant knows how to manage tough situations up close. He's got flexible hips, which will help Caleb Plant to evade shots from Saul Canelo Alvarez, who is more than just a formidable pressure fighter. In this Canelo Plant matchup, Caleb Plant's biggest asset, most certainly, is his footwork. Unlike Canelo, whose feet aren't the fastest, Caleb has the ability to offset his opponents just by his footwork. Caleb Plant is brash and has a bit of that swag that comes with being an undefeated world champion, having defended his portion of the world title a total of 4 times. Now let's talk about Caleb Plant's unknowns. Although I rate Caleb Plant as a fighter for his skill, for his inner belief, Canelo will be Plant's first real step up. I mean, no disrespect, but who has Caleb Plant fought in his pro career so far? How will Caleb Plant take a shot from a legitimate boxing elite who knows how to box, set traps, and knows how to stop opponents when he senses the end is near? How will Caleb Plant deal with Canelo's tremendous physical strength? How is Caleb Plant's stamina? Caleb Plant isn't known for his knockouts. As a matter of fact, Plant only has recorded 2 stoppage wins in his last 7 fights, has gone the full distance in the other 5, 2 of them being 10-round fights. And in many fights, Caleb Plant has faded as the fight dragged on. So how will Caleb Plant deal with a fighter who will bring the fight to him? How will Caleb Plant successfully keep Canelo off? Will he even be able to? There is levels within boxing, so either in Canelo versus Plant we'll witness Sweet Hands' true greatness, or Caleb Plant will be exposed to the harsh reality inside the truth machine that being the boxing ring in the MGM Garden Arena on November 6, 2021. Canelo's attributes. Canelo versus Plant will be Canelo's 20th world title fight, which alone is almost as many fights as Caleb Plant's entire pro career thus far. The quality of opposition just in his relative brief stint at 168, successfully unifying twice against unbeaten Brits Callum Smith and Billy Joe Saunders, is something Caleb Plant, a career super middleweight, hasn't done just yet. Not to mention the elite fighters Canelo has faced. Danny Jacobs, Gennady Golovkin twice, and a close to his prime Floyd Mayweather Jr., just to name a few. Just take a look at Canelo versus Triple G2, which turned out to be Ring Magazine's fight of 2018, in which Saul Canelo Alvarez took some of Gennady Golovkin's best shot flush on the chin. And it's not that Canelo has to solely rely on his chin. The loss to Mayweather back in September of 2013 most certainly has inspired Canelo to make great improvements. I mean, he might not have faced Sweet Hands just yet. However, Saul Canelo Alvarez most certainly inside the ring has dealt with some fast hands, heavy hands, and hands with volume. Canelo can be slick when he wants to be up close, and he definitely can make Caleb Plant miss and pay. So do not be surprised by Canelo's counterpunching opportunities, which he will capitalize on when they present themselves during Canelo versus Plant. Being a 4-division world champion, having held world titles from 154 up to 175, Saul Canelo Alvarez has been in big fights before on the biggest of stages and will be very focused for this particular task at hand, dealing with Caleb Plant in order to become the first ever 168-pound undisputed champion of the world. As for Canelo's unknowns, even Billy Joe Saunders, whose best days were at middleweight, not super middleweight, offset Canelo in their fight back in May of 2021. Unlike Billy Joe, Caleb Plant is closer to his prime and in my opinion has the better balance, less mileage on the clock, and overall better footwork. How will Saul Canelo Alvarez deal with Caleb's legs? Also apparent in the Billy Joe Saunders fight, which was part of the reason that the fight against the then undefeated Brit seemed close, at least on some of the scorecards, is the fact that Canelo starts slow and his shot output is low, which is very standard for Canelo fights historically. What he gives up in volume, he compensates in accuracy and shot selection. Caleb Plant has the faster feet and is very slick, i.e. Plant has the style that has troubled Canelo in the past. Floyd Mayweather toyed with Canelo even though the Mexican was a green 23-year-old at the time. Later on, Canelo also struggled in his fight with Cuban southpaw Erislandy Lara, Now, obviously, the two Triple G fights were close. I had Gennady Golovkin definitely winning the first. That said, Triple G style isn't Caleb Plant's style, unless Sweet Hands will pull out a surprise on November 6, 2021. It'll be very interesting to see how Canelo will deal with Caleb Plant's physical attributes. Not that Canelo hasn't before. I mean, Canelo beat both Callum Smith and Rocky Fielding, who in their respective fights held some sort of claim to the super middleweight throne. Fielding was on a 6-fight winning streak and the then regular WBA super middleweight world champion, and Smith was undefeated altogether. Both Rocky Fielding and Callum Smith have similar dimensions as Caleb Plant. That said, Caleb Plant fights completely different from both Callum Smith and Rocky Fielding and will pose very different challenges to Canelo, which the Mexican admitted himself.
He have a good moves, good jab. He's a good boxer.
Number 3. Preparations. Caleb Plant and his team know that he is in the biggest and toughest challenge of his whole pro career so far. So during this camp, Caleb Plant did get a visit from Hall of Famer and two-weight unified world champion Andre SOG Ward. At the Canelo Plant press conference, boxing fans were gifted a sneak preview, doing a great job in promoting their November 6th fight in the process.
But he can pop positive for something and get suspended for 6 months.
Don't make excuses.
But somehow
don't make excuses before the fight.
You're a cheater.
Don't make excuses before the fight.
You got suspended for 6 months. You're a cheater.
Say whatever you say.
Then there was the infamous scuffle. Although both guys used their hands, Canelo did show off two attributes: his physical strength and his quick reflexes. Now, if you watch the Canelo versus Plant press conference, I'm sure you can't wait to see the actual Canelo versus Plant fight on November 6th. Number 4, the actual fight. I see the fight starting off a bit slow with both guys measuring each other. I envision Caleb Plant establishing the distance, utilizing his jab, his footwork, his height and reach. And similarly, I think Canelo will use these opening rounds to measure Plant using feints and his low volume tactics to systematically break down Caleb Plant. Going into the mid rounds, however, I see Canelo amp up the pressure, getting close to Plant, targeting the body in order to take away Plant's legs, and that's when we'll exactly see what Caleb Plant's character is made of on this stage. I do think that Plant will have some successes here and there, use his movement, his ring IQ, catching Saul Canelo Alvarez a couple of times, yet once the Mexican gets into his groove, hit Caleb Plant to the body a couple of times, I see the IBF champion start to gas and slow down as Canelo goes on to break Caleb Plant down even more and eventually finish the job. Number 5, ringside's unofficial prediction. So if I were a betting man, I'd take Canelo Alvarez by stoppage somewhere from round 7 onwards. And that's no disrespect to Caleb Plant. I mean, I rate Plant as a fighter. He's got very good skills, has some advantages over Saul Canelo Alvarez. I admire Caleb Plant for living through his struggles in life to get where he is at right now. And I think Caleb Plant is really confident in his ability and that it's not just all talk. I actually think Caleb got a little bit under Canelo's skin, which makes Canelo versus Plant not only a historical fight, but also a bit of a grudge match where both Caleb Plant and Saul Canelo Alvarez have something to prove to their fans, to each other, and to themselves. That said, based off the record, based on fights in the past, based on experience and all the attributes put together, I think that at this point in time, Canelo Alvarez will be too much for Caleb Plant. However, this is boxing. The ring is the ultimate truth machine, and this fight will be the ultimate platform to show off greatness. So on November 6, 2021, Caleb can plant, no pun intended, his flag in the history books by defeating arguably the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world today and become the first ever undisputed super middleweight champion in the process. And Caleb Plant will need to be at his very best, putting in an all-time great performance to be able to have a chance and possibly beat Saul Canelo Alvarez. For us boxing fans, there's so much to look forward to and grateful about regarding Canelo Alvarez versus Caleb Plant. Either we will get the expected outcome of the towering force in boxing that continues to be, or we will learn that Caleb Plant isn't just a brash 20-something-year-old who happens to be an undefeated world champion just because he had very questionable opposition so far. In that case, us boxing fans would witness 2021's biggest upset and one of boxing's biggest upset altogether. May the best man win, and I wish fight fans a great fight. These are just my observations. What are yours? Let us know in the comments below. If you like more content like this and you haven't done yet, don't forget to subscribe, give a thumbs up, and hit that notification bell, as it helps the channel out a lot, i.e. inspire us to make more quality content for y'all. As always, thank you so much for your support and welcome to Ringside Stories. Now, if you've done that already, you're amazing. We already know that. You are the true undisputed world champion. So next time, Ringsiders, this is your host, Boxing's Objective Observer with Ringside Stories. Thanks for watching and have a legendary day.